The largemouth bass. The painted turtle. The pumpkin seed. All of this and more on this episode of The Submarine World of Jacques Cousteau.
Welcome to the headquarters of the Cachalot Marinological Society. What do you mean, it's not a word? Of course it's a word. Just tell me French. Welcome to the headquarters of the Cachalot Marinological Society, our multinational non-profit marine research collective. I am Jacques-Yves Cousteau, and I am here under the watchful portrait of our founder, Edouard Cachalot, with my trusty crewmate, Serge, to set the stage for our adventures in this episode. We are about to set forth for here. Here. Camp Cachalot, Plymouth, Massachusetts, to examine the native aquatic life of the lovely five-mile pond. It is sometimes serene, sometimes savage, but it is always beautiful. Let us embark.
Captain Cousteau awaits the arrival of his vessel, the Sea Nymph, along the shore of Five Mile Pond. He won't be kept waiting for long, as it soon pulls into view, with intrepid crewman Robert at the helm.
Let me show you my ship. This is the Sea Nymph, the main research vessel of the Cachalot Marinological Society. We purchased this as surplus after the untimely loss of our last ship, the Orca, to the vicious teeth of a 3-ton, 25-foot white shark. Unfortunately, Serge had neglected to pay our insurance policy, so we had to downsize dramatically.
The crew takes their stations aboard the Sea Nymph and set forth for the morning to deploy their remote cameras at various locations around the pond. These cameras, protected from the pressure of the deep by a specialized housing of Captain Cousteau's own design, will hopefully reveal some of the creatures lurking in the depths of Five Mile Pond. Here we see First Mate Serge dropping one of the cameras into the channel of the lagoon before setting off for the first dive of the day.
Our cameras in the morning look through the beautiful clear waters of Five Mile Pond to capture some of the beautiful underwater creatures in their native environment. Seeing life in all its many underwater forms reminds me of why I first fell in love with the mineralogical science when I was just a boy working under the esteemed Edouard Cachalot, whose love for the water knew no bounds and was as vast as the infinite universe.
The crew enters the warm waters of Five Mile Pond, with Cousteau free diving while Philippe and Serge swim with cameras. In the depths, we find some strange cone-shaped objects. A blue anchor, currently free from holding anything fast. And even a wreck from the golden age of sail, its mast rotting, hull beginning to be covered by debris, in water shallow enough that the remnants are bathed in sunlight.
Thank you.
Emerging from the gloom, we encounter our first denizens of the pond, a pair of largemouth bass. Largemouths are the most sought-after game fish in Five Mile Pond, but they are a relatively new arrival. No largemouth bass swam in Massachusetts waters until they were introduced for sport over 100 years ago in nearly all of the ponds in the Commonwealth. This specimen has been attracted to the bait placed near one of the remote cameras. The notches in its dorsal fin and tail tell a story of battles fought, but it's clearly a fighter, not a thinker, as it struggles to eat a rubber fish separated from an angler's line. Stupid fish, can't you tell that's not food? The largemouth bass is an olive green or gray fish marked by a stripe of darker blotches along both flanks. They can live as long as 16 years and reach sizes of nearly 30 inches in length and 25 pounds in weight, although specimens found in Five Mile Pond are typically much smaller. 5 to 6 pound fish are caught frequently by anglers. A pair of painted turtles, also attracted to the bait at the remote camera, approach, but quickly back away. We soon see why, as Philippe swims into view in front of the camera, taking time to wave to his fans. Get back to work, Philippe. We have a busy schedule today. The painted turtle is the most common of several species of turtle found in Five Mile Pond. Subsisting on a diet of fish, insects, and aquatic plants, these smooth-shelled turtles are readily recognizable by their red and yellow markings and shell segments in straight rows. Adult turtles reach 5 to 7 inches in length, and they can often be spotted basking on logs around the pond, enjoying the warmth of the sun. Adult females can often be seen outside the pond in late spring, burying clutches of eggs in the nearby sand. When their plastron, or bottom shell, is wet, they can adhere to smooth, flat surfaces, as they are also nature's suction cup. This swift, sleek swimmer is another game fish found in Five Mile Pond, the native chain pickerel. Adult pickerel in Five Mile are typically 16 to 18 inches in length, with larger specimens occasionally exceeding 24 inches. Mature pickerel are patient hunters, waiting concealed by cover to rapidly lunge out at their prey with sharp-toothed, bony jaws. This pickerel spends a long time lingering right in front of our camera trap, presumably trying to identify the source of the fishy odor in the water. It eventually strikes at the mackerel tin containing the bait, but is ultimately disappointed in its attempt to gain access to the tasty morsels within. It's a little known fact that pickerel are rebellious fish in their youth, and huge fans of punk music. While they can't wear denim vests due to a vexing lack of arms, many sport facial piercings, like this specimen with a metal lip ring in the shape of a lure. They compensate for their sadness at being unable to wear clothing by bearing distinctive chainmail-like patterns on their skin, from which they get their name. You can see this pattern clearly on this pickerel, patiently waiting for smaller fish to swim into range near our baited camera trap, only to be displaced by a hungry turtle.
Mm-hmm.
Life aboard the sea nymph is not all the work, and the crew takes a meal in the galley, followed by a brief siesta to enjoy their various hobbies. But the respite is short, and we take to the water again in the afternoon to reload the remote cameras and swim with the little fishes.
The little fishes that Clouseau wants to swim with would certainly include these tiny banded killifish, which reach mere inches long as adults. Killies usually prefer the shallow sandy water very close to shore, and large groups or shoals can be seen there, often mistakenly called minnows by people visiting Five Mile. While the shallow water near shore and the species' shoaling behavior help protect them from their predators, including the speedy pickerel, it does subject them to children, who can often be seen chasing the shoals of killies swimming through the shallows near the camp's waterfront. Killifish feed on numerous small invertebrates, especially the larvae of mosquitoes and midges. Their large numbers consume massive quantities of mosquito larvae and help control the population of those flying, biting jerks. Killifish aren't the only small creature swimming in Five Mile Pond. It is also home to a large variety of insects and other small invertebrates, like this water mite, which paddled in front of one of our cameras, nearly 10 feet below the surface. Another native denizen of Five Mile Pond is the pumpkinseed sunfish. These panfish make solitary, crater-like nests in sandy areas of Five Mile every spring. Pumpkin seeds are brightly colored, with copper, green, and blue-patterned sides, and a red crescent on the so-called ear spot on their gill flap. They are occasionally mistaken for bluegill sunfish, which are less common in Five Mile Pond. Pumpkin seeds are an important prey fish of larger species in Five Mile, including largemouth and pickerel. But despite their small size, they will aggressively defend their nests from other fish, flaring their gill covers, charging, chasing, and biting invaders. We return to our lagoon camera, where a largemouth bass has identified the source of the delicious fishy scent of our bait, and is valiantly trying to consume the entire can. It is quickly joined by a pickerel and a painted turtle, and all three animals continue to try to gain access to the well-armored mackerel within, performing for our camera as they do so. It's that same clueless largemouth from our first segment. At least this time, it's trying to get it actual food, even if it's too well protected to be eaten. Finally, Clouseau's camera captures a brief glimpse of the brassy yellow, olive-banded yellow perch, another of the frequently caught native species in Five Mile, hiding amidst the reeds near the shore.
For our final adventure of the day, Serge and I enter the water in search for the giant mongo, legendary and ancient snapping turtle of 5 Mile Pond. Lady Fortune smiles down upon us through the waves as soon we find the large turtle swimming in the clear water.
This so-called mongo is a large common snapping turtle. The family of snapping turtles goes back at least 90 million years in North America, and modern examples, like mongo, still have the dinosaur-like appearance of their ancient ancestors. They can be very aggressive, especially when out of the water. Their species name, Serpentina, means snake-like, and they can stretch and twist their agile necks to reach most parts of their carapace, making them dangerous to handle. Their nostrils are at the very tip of their beak, and they extend their necks like a snorkel, sometimes remaining mostly under debris in shallow water, awaiting prey, stretching their necks periodically to breathe. We do not know for certain how long they live in the wild, but the evidence so far suggests a lifespan of as much as 100 years. Snapping turtles are the largest predators that reside in 5 Mile Pond. They are active hunters that will eat nearly anything they can swallow, from invertebrates to fish, frogs, smaller reptiles including other turtles, and even the occasional waterfowl or unwary small mammal. They also make delicious soup.
Suddenly, without warning, the giant turtle races at us, violently attacking Serge. I drop the camera in the chaos that ensues.
Serge! Serge!
What's the matter? What's the matter?
Mongo! Mongo! Mongo took Serge! Mongo took Serge! Mongo took Serge! 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 Oh, Serge!
Today, we step close to the edge of the abyss, and the abyss reach out and grab Serge. But Lady Fortune frowned, turned upside down into a new smile, and Serge emerged from the bloody surf a moment later, gravely wounded by the creature, but still alive, although brave Serge continues to make light of his injuries.
This is just a flesh wound.
I blame myself for his condition, as I am the captain. I am the sea, and the sea is me. And if you are what you eat, Mongo is now Serge. So concludes our marinological adventures of 5 Mile Pond. Join us next time as our adventures take us to new waters and fresh horizons, always seeking to reveal the mysteries of the deep to you, our viewers. Au revoir, et bonne chance.